So, hello everyone. This video is in demand. So why? Because I have given a short where I discussed about how to balance a chemical reaction with potassium dichromate and your sulfuric acid. Okay, so everybody told me to give the full reaction. So, please, I'm explaining the full reaction out here in acidic medium. So, because K2Cr2O7 to SO4, okay, sulfuric acid only. Okay, so first we will do this reaction, that is your Cr2O7 2 minus plus SO3 2 minus, which gives you Cr3 plus and plus SO4 2 minus. So this is the question which was there in the short, and I have to give you the full explanation. Okay, and to solve another question, and that is your Zn plus NO3 minus. Okay, this is in H plus, that means you can say in acidic medium, Zn2 plus plus N2O. Okay, another thing is we are going to do the same equation in basic medium also, so that you understand how to solve equations in both acidic and your basic medium. Okay, which is very much important for you to understand. So these two questions we are going to do, and this will solve all your doubts based on your balancing the chemical equation. Okay, so the first one we are going to solve now. See here, see very carefully, Cr2O7 2 minus plus SO3 2 minus. Here it is giving you Cr 3 plus, it is forming, and plus SO4 2 minus. Carefully note the situations. See here, first, for balancing a chemical equation, we need, what are the things we need? That is your oxidation number. Okay, and I have discussed in detail what is oxidation number in other video. Please do check that video. I'm not repeating this. Oxidation number, how to find the oxidation number, it is there. And oxidation number, and also we can say valency. It is not same as valency, but almost same. You please check the video again. So this first we are going to do, and then we are going to balance elements. Balance your elements and charge. Balance charge and elements. Okay, so these are the two things we are going to do. Okay, so now here reduction and oxidation both are taking place in an equation. So these are also called your redox reactions also. Now, first we will do the oxidation half cell. So if I have taken SO3 2 minus first, okay, and SO4 2 minus. See, you don't need to understand, or you don't need to know which one is your oxidation half cell and reduction half cell. You will find out yourself only just by doing this. See, first write these elements this way, and then first find the oxidation number. So we know, okay, this is a valency of oxygen is minus 2. So now 3 2 just 6, 6 minus 2, it is plus 4. So sulfur out here is plus 4 oxidation number. Then oxidation number again I'm taking, so 4 2 are 8 minus 2, that is plus 6. So it is becoming plus 6. So what is happening? It is losing electron. How many electron? 2 electrons it is losing. This molecule is losing 2 electrons. So this is your oxidation half cell. So this one is getting, okay, now see how many oxygen is there. See here, there is 3 oxygen and here it is 4. Is it not, if I add one oxygen out here, that means it becomes 4 oxygen, is it not? So what are we going to do? So we know this, the medium is acidic, so if I add water molecule to it, okay, in this water molecule, so what is happening, is it not 3 plus 1 4, it is forming 4 oxygen out here. So oxygen is balanced. Now what is left, that is only hydrogen is not balanced. So what we are going to do, we are going to add 2H plus out in the right hand side. Why? We know because this is in your acidic medium, so acid will be produced in the reaction only after oxidation. We know this, so we are adding this way. Now what do the other half, that is your Cr2O7 2 minus. This is forming Cr3 plus. And always remember one thing, in acidic medium only, this Cr2O7, or you can say MnO4, these molecules, that is permanganate, or you can say dichromate, they give your elemental chromate or elemental manganese. Remember that in case of your, you can say acidic medium. But in case of basic medium, we will see next what happens. In case of basic medium, what happens is that this molecule only, they will form, they will bind with oxygen. oxygen to form their oxide, chromium oxide or N2O, something, some oxides will be formed in basic medium. So that is the difference. Now see, here, see R2O7, so again, put the oxidation number 7 to the 14, 14 minus 2, it should be plus 12. So here, chromium is 2 chromium is this, so it should be plus 6 for both each. So here it is plus 3. So if it is 2 chromium, I am putting 2 out here to balance it. Okay, now see how many oxygen molecule is there? 7. So we need how many molecules of water? Tell me. So we need to add here oxygen 7 H2O. So if I'm adding 7 H2O, okay, so how many 7 to the 14 H plus should be there? So medium is acidic, so always there will be H plus in this medium. And how many first I have forgotten, see here, this chromium plus 6, it is forming to plus 3. That means it is gaining electron. How many electron did it gain? It gained 3 electron to form the from Cr3 plus. Okay, so this is your reduction half, sir. Okay, now multiply this by 2 and multiply this equation by 3. Why? First, we have to balance the charge. See, by multiplying this by 3, it is becoming 3 to the 6 electron. You just look at the electron and then balance the equation. So 3 to the 6, again, see this electron and this electrons get cancelled. So now we will write like this, 3SO3 2 minus plus 2Cr2O7 2 minus. First, write all these things and then you write this one. 3SO4 2 minus plus 2 to the 4 Cr3 plus. Now we will balance the water molecule. See here, here it is 3 water molecule and here it is how many water molecules? 7 to the 14. So 14 water molecule on the right hand side and left hand side only 3. If we minus it, if I take this water molecule to that side and if I subtract it, how many water molecules are left out here? Because 7 to the 14 minus 3 is 11 H2O. Okay, and see here it is 14 H plus, so 14 to the 28, and here it is how many H plus? 3 to the 6. So 28 minus 6 is your 22 H plus, is it not? See, 11 to the 22, so in the left hand side we got 22 H plus, so your equation is balanced, hence your answer is correct. Okay, so this was the total video on the topic which you wanted me to do. And then we will go to solve this question. Now we are going to solve this question in both acidic and your basic medium. How we are going to do? So let's start. So your question was zinc plus NO3 minus in plus N2O. Okay, so you have to solve this one. Now see, zinc is forming Zn2+. First, write the oxidation state. Oxidation state is here, it is 0, it is plus 2 out here. From 0, it is becoming plus 2. What is happening? Loss of 2 electrons. Okay, so this is your oxidation half cell. Now, NO3 minus, okay, it is forming your N2O. First, write oxidation number. So here we know it is minus 2 for oxygen. So 2, 3 is 6, minus 1 of the charge. Okay, so 2, 3 is 6, minus 1, that is 5. So nitrogen here, it is plus 5. And here it is minus 2. So it should be plus 1. Because see, here it should be plus 2, total charge. But on nitrogen is plus 2, but it is N2. So each nitrogen will have plus 1 charge. Okay, so from plus 5 to come to plus 1, how many electron did it gain? Tell me. From plus 5 to become is forming your plus 1. So how many electrons is it losing? It is gaining 4 electron. Okay, it is gaining how many electron? It is gaining your 4 electron to give N plus 1 nitrogen state. Okay, and now oxygen is to be balanced. And this is, we know, it is an acidic medium. So in acidic medium, this is how many molecules of oxygen is here? It is 3. And here it is how much? Only 1. So is it not, if I put 2H2O, so 2 plus 1 becomes 3. 3, oxygen is balanced. Now when oxygen is balanced, we have to balance the hydrogen. So put 2 2s are 4. So it should be 4H plus in the left hand side, since it is an acidic medium. Okay, now multiply this equation by 2. Balance the charge first. Balancing the charge, just cancel out your charge. Cancel out the charge. And then you write your equation. That is twice Zn plus NO3 minus, okay, plus 4H plus gives you 2Zn2+ plus N2O and plus 2 molecules of water. So this is your balance equation in your acidic medium. Now the same equation we are going to do in basic medium. What it is? Zn plus NO3 in basic medium, it is given to you in question that it forms Zn O2 2 minus and plus NH3 ammonia it forms. So first write the oxidation upsell, that is zinc. Zinc, you know, it is usually just gives out electron. So let me write ZnO2, okay, 2 minus. Now this is the charge is given. First, find the oxidation state. And if you don't know how to find oxidation number, please go through the videos which I have done before. So from 0, it is forming, see here, minus 2. 2 2s are 4. 4 minus 2, 2 is plus 2 again. So it is losing 2 electron again out here. Okay, in basic medium, since oxygen is there in the right hand side, now we have to we know in basic medium, medium is basic, that means with zinc what is there, base is there in the solution, so I can add HO minus ion to balance the oxygen. So in this case I'm not adding what, hydrogen ion, I'm adding hydroxyl ion. Okay, so how many hydroxyl ion should be there? So if it is 2 molecule, 2 oxygen in the right hand side, it should be 2HO. So if it is, if I am adding 2 molecules of hydroxyl ion, I have to add here how many hydrogen it should be. That means I cannot add out here twice H plus, because this is not your acidic medium anymore. So it is basic medium. We have to add here water molecule. So now I cannot put 2, I have to put 4. If I am putting 4 out here, that time if I put again 2 molecules of water out here, so oxygen is balanced and 2 2s are 4 here, hydrogen is also balanced. So here I have to put 4 molecules of hydroxyl ion, and then in the right hand side there should be water molecule, no more acid out here. Okay, in the second case again write NO3 minus, it is forming what, ammonia. Now see, now there is a trick again, minus 2, 3 to the 6, minus 1, here it is plus 5, and here we know hydrogen is plus 1, so now nitrogen becomes what, from plus, if it is, it becomes minus 3. So from plus 5 it is forming minus 3. Just imagine how much electrons it has gained. From plus 5 to forming plus 0, it is 5 electron, and again 3 more electron, 3 more electron it has seen. So total 8 electrons it is taking up to form NH3 ammonia. Okay, and how many water molecules of oxygen left out here? 3 molecules of oxygen. So I have to put how many what out here? I have to put hydroxyl ion out here, but how many hydroxyl ion now? It should be how much? See out here, there is there should be 3. If I'm putting, is it balancing? Just see, if I put 3 out here, that means, okay, let me put 3 out here. So 3 HO and here 3. That means how many hydrogen is again there? 6. So 3 H2O water molecule I have to add. I'm not going to add any more acid. It is, I have to add water. So these 3 2s are 6. 6 molecules of water. And how many? Now see, 6 oxygen molecule now. So what to do? Is it balanced? No. So what I have to add? I have to add out here 6. 6 HO molecule I'll have to add. Okay. So if I'm adding 6 hydroxyl ion, then it is 3 to the 6. Hydrogen is also getting balanced. And your oxygen is also getting balanced. So it should be 6 HO minus ion, not 3. Now see. Done of hydrogen and oxygen balancing. So first now we have to balance the charge. Here it is 8 electron and here it is 4. So multiply this by how much? By 4. Okay, so 4 2s are 8. Now this and this is get cancelled. I'm not multiplying this equation anymore. Why? It's not required, because 4 2s are 8, 8 electron got cancelled. So the equation will be 4 Zn plus, now don't write hydroxyl ion, just write these main terms, 4 Zn plus your NO3 minus, and it is forming your what, 4 ZnO2 2 minus plus your NH3 ammonia. Okay, now we will write the hydroxyl ion. Now see here, how many hydroxyl ion? 4 into 4, 4 4s are 16, and here it is 6. So 16 minus 6, how many 16 minus HO ion, here it is 6, so it should be how much, 10 HO minus out here. And in this right hand side, see, 4 2s are 8 water molecule is there, and here it is how many water molecules, only 3. So this side it is more, so 8 minus 3 it is 5 H2O. Is it not? It is H10 HO minus and H5 H2O, so it is balanced. Now see, always remember, if it is half, there is, if water molecule is should be always half of the hydroxyl ion, that means hydroxyl ion will always be double the number of water molecule in the basic medium. You should always remember that. So while doing the sum, if you are confused, if you're not understanding, just remember oxygen water molecule will always be half of the hydroxyl ion, so hydroxyl ion should be doubled. All right, so done with all the balancing of hydroxyl ions, and your basic medium and acidic medium balancing equation. So if you have any doubt, please pin me in the comment and I will do some other chapter or other topics, and I'm not taking any more example. If you want to me to take some more examples, do pin me in the comment, then I'll take some more examples also. Okay.